Hey, it's Ramsey. Welcome to the third episode of this series on getting started with ClickUp. In the previous episodes, I showed you how to create your account and manage your tasks. If you haven't watched them, you can check out the link in the playlist in the description. Now today, we're taking you next level by exploring more advanced features like templates and automations. This will help you unlock ClickUp to its full potential. And to take your skills even further, you can download the mini course down in the link in the description below. Now let's get started.
If you run through each steps, you will understand that each of these features combined will make your project management run almost by itself. Now we're going to talk about a feature that I've mentioned in the previous video in this tutorial series, and it's going to be custom fields. Custom fields are a way to track information that is not by default in ClickUp. So if we open up a ClickUp task, as you can see, a task can have status, dates, time estimates, this kind of standard information that you find in any project management software. You can track different types of custom information like dropdowns, texts, and everything. Today, we're gonna take the use case of a web design agency. This web design agency runs through these steps that are here by default, and it has different clients represented by lists, and you want this project to be able to be reused to each of these clients. So I'll show you how through the whole video. Next, there's a team space, and I'll show you what it's used for. The first thing we're going to do is create a few custom fields. Custom fields are a way to track custom information in ClickUp. Now, if you open up a task here, you can see it has a status, dates, estimates. This is kind of the default information that you find in any project management software. But what makes ClickUp very different is that you can track quite a lot of custom information. So here we're going to track the teams that has to do one of these tasks, for example. So we're going to create a dropdown and we're going to name it teams. We're going to put some options. So in this specific web design project, we have a project manager, we have a design team, and we have a tech team. And we can even add some colors if we want to make it fancy. I'm going to save it. I'm going to wrap my tasks, and that way I can assign each step to the right team. So I can say get customer assets is to be done by project, client brief, make the wireframes, validate, design, then it's gonna be tech, and the weekly meetings are handled by the project team. That's great. We're now tracking on each task, which team has to work on it. And next we wanna track the project phase, the step we're at in this whole project. So what we can do is add a second custom field called dropdown. Now we're gonna add each step in the right phase. So this is onboarding, this is conception, and this is client delivery. Perfect. So now what we can do is actually group our tasks through these different phases. So you can go here to group, custom fields, and select phase. And that way we're able to split our project through each different phase and get a clearer view. I've showed how it works in the previous video. If you don't understand how grouping, filtering, and views work, you can go watch it. But otherwise, just remember that if you learn how to use them properly, it will really save you time in getting more clarity into your project. Now I've added some pretty common custom fields here, like the team, the phase, but what if I want to track the difference between the time estimated on the task and the time actually spent? There's actually a formula field in ClickUp that will allow you to track any type of custom calculation between two colons. So we're gonna add a colon and we're gonna call it formula time difference, and we're gonna add our colon. And then we're gonna put our calculation. Now you can click the advanced editor here and you can have some very advanced calculation, but it's quite complex. That's why I've done another video regarding advanced formulas in ClickUp that you can go check out. But if we stay here in our very simple calculation, what we can do is subtract the time estimate from the time track. So I'm gonna select the time estimate and I'm gonna do a subtraction and I'm gonna tick the time track. Perfect. I'll pick calculate. And what it does is that it actually makes a difference between this colon and that one. I'm going to bring that colon here. And what we can do, I'm going to say it took us 6 hours to get the customer assets. And now if I do the sum of that colon, of the time difference colon, I go to calculate and sum. What we can see is that we're at -5. We went overboard on that phase. We spent 5 hours more than planned. So combining the formula and the calculation at the bottom of your grouping is a great way to get some KPI on your project. So you can calculate some budget, some time, some points, some difference between different values. This is not as powerful as a spreadsheet, but it can definitely help you out get a quick view of your overall finances or time tracking. Now that we've tracked custom information like the time difference or the team or the phase of each of our tasks in our list, we're gonna see if we can systemize it a bit more. If I go down here, we have a weekly meeting task. And what happens with a weekly meeting is that it occurs every week, right? What if ClickUp could do that for us? Meaning creating a new task every week for that meeting so that we can take note in that tasks or add some attachments or something like that. What we can do here is create a subtask in that weekly meeting task to track each of our weekly meetings. And I'm gonna add my subtask and call it weekly and week number, for example. That way, each time it creates, we can put the actual week number. And now I'm gonna make use of a feature in ClickUp called recurring tasks. So if I click on the due date here, and I say my weekly meeting will start on the 8th of April for the first time, I can actually set it to recurring. So I can click here on set recurring, and ClickUp offers me a few recurring options. So you have daily, weekly, monthly. I'm gonna stick with weekly, and then I'm gonna pick on schedule, which means that even if you haven't closed the previous weekly meeting task, ClickUp will create a new one. And then I'm gonna update the status to open. That means that if the previous weekly meeting is in a certain status, say it's done or in progress, the new one will be open so that each time it's a new task that's brand new, that's open. And then before saving, you're gonna go into options and you're gonna tick off the comments. You can also tick off the description if you've added some specific information. You wanna do that because if you use the comments or if you use the description for that previous weekly meeting, it will copy and paste to the new one, and we don't want the previous week's information to come to the new weekly meeting. So I've ticked that off, I click save, and then save again. And this way there's a little cycle icon that starts, and it tells you it's the start of a recurring weekly meeting. That's a great way to automate that aspect, so that each time we start a new client project, we know that we have a recurring weekly meeting task that's pre-set up for that project. Okay, our project looks great. But what if you don't want to show everything to the people you're working with? What if your designers or your tech team are freelancers and you don't want them to see the whole project? What you can do is right-click on the task and go into sharing and permissions and make some tasks private. But you don't really want to be doing that because that's going to require you a lot of clicks and a lot of tracking. It's really hard to follow through which task you've shared, which tasks you haven't. What I recommend is to create second lists for the teams that are actually going to work on that project. So say you're going to share that web design list team with your client and the project manager that will follow through the whole project. And you want to share the design list with the designers and the tech list with the tech people. Now, there's a feature that's amazing in ClickUp, and it's called tasks in multiple lists. And we're going to go into a diagram so that I show you how it works. Now, here's a little diagram. We have our main list, like our client list, and then we have other lists, like our dev list or our design list. And what happens with tasks in multiple lists is that our task can be hosted in our client list, but also pop up in our design list or in our dev list. It will appear in both lists just with that feature. And what happens there is that if the design team wants to edit that task, they want to update it, the changes reflect on our main client list. I'm gonna show you how it looks. So let's get back to ClickUp. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick a design task here and I'm gonna right click on it and go to add to another list. And then I'm gonna add it to the list called design. And if I go to the design list, the task has appeared. It's both here and in the web design list. And I can preview that just by changing the status. If I change the status for open to review and I go into the web design list, as you can see, the status has changed here too. It's also in review. And if anyone makes changes in that list, it will reflect in the main client list. So that's amazing, because then you can go into sharing and permissions and just give access in that design list to the right person, to the employees or freelancers that work on your design. You just go there, you select them, and you don't have to give them access to the main list. Now there's a second way to do that. You can add a colon and look for the colon called lists. Then what you can do is actually pick any task and add the task to another list. This is exactly the same behavior. If you add it to the design team and we go into the design list here, it will pop up as well. So these two do the same thing. But what if we can go even further and make that automated? So I'm going to show you what I want. I want that as soon as I change the design team custom field, it adds the task to the design team list. and it assigns the task to the head of design. That way, I don't have to do these two manually. And if you start to have that logic of automations, and I'll show you how automations work, you'll definitely save hours on ClickUp. That's what I do for my clients. So when we start with a client at Upsys, we try to understand their workflow, and then we understand what we can automate, both in ClickUp and externally. Because understanding what can be automated is the first step to systemizing your business. If you want to know more about that and you're interested to book a discovery call, there is a link below in the description. Now let me get back to ClickUp and create these automations. So design team selected, attached to design team, assigned to head of design, dev team selected, assigned to dev, assigned to lead developer. I'm back in ClickUp and I'm going to go into the automations here in the top right, and we're going to add an automation. So what it says is basically if the custom field changes to design. So I'm going to go into custom field changes. I'm going to pick my custom fields called team, and I'm going to say changes to design. Then please add the task to the list called design, and please assign it to Diane, which is my head of design. And then I'm going to create my automation. What I like to do is name my automations so that I understand what they do without having to open them. I'm going to name it design team add to design list. Then I'm going to do the same thing for the tech team. So I'm going to duplicate this in the current location, and I'm going to change the team to tech, and I'm going to add it to the list called tech. That's in my delivery space, and I'm going to change the assignee. So I'm going to remove that one, and I'm going to select Lucas, which is our tech lead. So I'm going to duplicate this automation, and all I have to do now is rename it tech team add to tech list. That's amazing. I'm going to show you another automation that I often put on my client workspace to kind of enforce the use of ClickUp and of its deadlines. I'll create an automation that will leave a comment each time a task is not closed and has hit deadline. We're going to say when the due date arrives and the status is not closed, is not any of closed, perfect, then leave a comment and say, this has hit deadline, any updates? This way, each time a time has a deadline, it will leave a comment and it will notify the person that is watching this task, either the assignee or someone that has created or is collaborating on this task. Then I'm going to click create. And this way we have a few automations and we already started systemizing our business with these advanced ClickUp features. You've probably started to understand that if you start combining custom fields, formulas, recurring tasks, automations, you're putting your project management on autopilot, and your project manager just has to follow through and make sure that everything is aligning. But the last feature I'm going to show you is probably the one that's going to blow your mind. It's the one that makes ClickUp really different from any classic project management software. It's the one that makes it stand out and that makes it a real powerhouse for your business. What you have to understand is that you can templatize anything in ClickUp. You can create templates for tasks, lists, folders, space. You can save any setup you've made so that it's reused in the future. You can even create documents, templatize them, and reuse them for later, like meeting notes, briefs, SOPs. And this is what makes ClickUp great, because it really helps you standardize each of your processes so that in the future, you just have to copy and paste what has already been optimized and done. And that's why I love helping clients on ClickUp. That's why when we work together, we really try to understand what we can make a system, how we can get them out of the operations so that it runs almost by itself. We don't have time to create each line of template here, but what we can do is create two types of templates. We're going to create a task template and a list template. So let's start with a task template. Let's say the web page integration is something we do very often for clients. I'm going to use that task with all the subtasks below, so that I can trigger it again in a few clicks later. I'm going to do a right click on this task and go into templates and save as template. And I'm going to call it task website integration. And I'm going to customize the import items. I'm going to remove the comments and watchers. This way it will not reuse the existing comments that we have on that task. Make sure your task is clean before you do any template, because anything that's in that task will be saved into the template. Next, we're going to save the template. And our template is created in a few seconds. You can see it by the green tick here, and we can reuse it in our list. I'm going to click that little arrow here and I'm going to pin a template. I'm going to get my template that's called task website integration. Pin my template. Perfect. if I click that arrow here, that template is pinned. I can reuse it in the future in that specific list. I'm going to click Task Website Integration. And that way, it has been created with all the subtasks that we need. So it'll actually take a few seconds and go into the right grouping. Perfect. So as you can see it, we have our task website integration with all the sub-steps that we have to do. Now I can change the start and due dates. If that changes, you can use the Gantt view if you want to do that in batch faster. So now that template with the right custom information, the right custom fields, the right time estimates, potentially you could have added assignees, all of this is saved so that it can be reused to the infinite in the future. What if I could save not just the task, but my whole project? What if I could use this as a template for any new web design project I'm using in the future? I'm going to right click on that list called web design here, and I'm going to go into templates and save that whole list as a template. Now that's even better than task templates, and I'm going to show you why. We're going to name it web design client project, and we're going to save our template, and it's going to take a little bit more time to create, probably a few seconds. As you can see, it's created. Now, I'm going to create a new client project. Click plus here on this delivery space, and I'm going to create it from a template. And this time, I'm going to pick my web design client project and use it. I'm going to name the list to my new client's name. Say I've started with a client, and I'm going to put their name here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to remap the dates. I'm going to start that project in June because I've signed with that client, but it might be that we are not starting until then. And what ClickUp does is that it calculates the end date based on that whole project roadmap. And what you can do as well is skip weekends so that it doesn't put deadlines on Saturdays and Sundays. I'm going to also tick import all tasks as open. That way, if there was a task that was in progress, it can actually be reopened in the new client project. You shouldn't have to worry about archives, and you can use the template. Now, this is going to blow your mind. All of that project that we've set up with the right fields, with the right assignees, with the right automations, all of that is saved once and for all. And if I open each task up, it has the actual subtasks. If I go into my Gantt view, everything is starting on the 3rd of June. So we've saved our project and we've made sure that we can reuse it for any new client. And this is where ClickUp stands out compared to competition, because it really allows you to save your roadmap and reuse it for the future, which in custom fields, recurring tasks, automations, templates. And this is what makes ClickUp stand out for any other project software. This is what makes it a real potential powerhouse for your business. Now, we help agencies and service business set up ClickUp at Upsys. If you want to learn more, learn how we can help you systemize your agency and kind of coach you on how to make use of this project software to its full potential, you can just book a discovery call through the link below. Now, if you want to know more about ClickUp for agencies, there's a whole video series about that that I've made, and you can go watch it. It's in the description. Thank you for watching. I hope it helps you, and stay productive. I'll see you next time.